In this video, we are going to explain in easy steps how to set up the real-time trace function in Loader4 software. For this, first we need to check if the inverter is connected to Loader software. Then, we have to select and record signals from the inverter. And finally, we can optimize the signals, position, amplitude, for a better signals understanding. The real-time trace function is a very useful tool. It helps to optimize inverter performance and to analyze problems. Let's start by executing Fuji Loader 4 on our computer. This loader software is compatible with Fuji Mini C1 and C2, Fuji Echo, Fuji Multi, Fuji Ace, Fuji Mega, Fuji HVAC and Aqua, and Fuji Lift LM2 series. You can download the loader software free of charge from our website fujielectric-europe.com. First, we need to make sure the loader software is connected to an inverter. To do so, check that this box shows connected. Please remember that either an RS485 converter or a TPE1U are needed to communicate with the inverter. If this box shows disconnected or unknown, please make sure the message manager is installed. Also, check that COM settings are properly set. Select if your connection method is by RS485 converter or by TPE1U USB. In the case of RS485, make sure the right COM port is selected. In the case of TPE1U, make sure data in inverter via keypad is selected. Select Connected checkbox as well. If after all these checks the connection has not been established, make sure you have the right drivers for the RS485 converter or the TPE1U in your computer or the correct settings on the inverter. Start the real-time trace function by clicking on the real-time trace icon. Select Online and press OK. Offline will be used only in cases when no inverter is connected. When the real-time trace window appears, we can start by selecting the signals we want to monitor. To do so, go to the Advanced menu. As can be seen in the Advanced Settings window, we can select between analog and digital signals. Digital signals are related to the input and output terminals on the inverter, like X1, X2, Y3, Y4, etc. In other words, signals which only contain a value of either 0 or 1. Analog signals can be the analog inputs and outputs of the inverter, or any analog signal processed by the inverter, like motor speed, torque, or output current. Please note that, depending on the analog signals chosen, there will be more or less digital signals available to be monitored. We will show an example where 3 analog signals and 5 digital signals are used. The next step is to select which analog signals we want to monitor. As you can see, up to 4 analog channels are available. However, as we have chosen 3 analog signals in the previous setting, the 4th analog channel is disabled. Let's start by the setting on channel 1. In this case, we will choose reference speed, final, from the select signal menu. In channel 2, we will monitor the detected speed, in other words, the speed coming from an encoder. In the channel 3, we will select output current, instantaneous value. Let's now choose the digital signals. We start by digital inputs. In this case, we will monitor EN terminal, forward as a run command, and X1 as speed selection. In the rest of the channels, we will monitor the outputs Y1 and Y5. To do so, we need to change to output terminal in the select signal block. The last thing we can adjust is the sampling time. To do so, go to the other tab. Sampling time can be selected between a range going from 20 to 200 milliseconds. For better accuracy, 20 milliseconds is recommended. If there are electrical disturbances, higher sampling time is recommended. Now we are ready to monitor signals. To start monitoring signals, click the Start-Stop button. We can see that real-time trace is monitoring signals because lines with different colors are shown in the main window. Additionally, the yellow real-time trace signal is blinking. When the test is finished, please stop monitoring by pushing the start-stop button. In order to see the signals with a correct scale and in order, we can go to the graph position adjustment tag and click on Optimize Y-axis. Anyway, the signals can be moved if needed, or the scale can be modified in the same area. The time frame can be adjusted by selecting a different division. And the bigger the time frame per division is, the more information we will see on the same screen. And finally, the graphic can be saved on our computer by going to the File menu and selecting Save As. For additional information, please visit the site fujielectric-europe.com and download our manuals. That's all. Thank you very much for watching us. Domo arigato.